we cannot depend on one or two countries because of the natural disasters and so on. So we definitely need to diversify. That has been happening. I was very pleased with the historic announcements by companies like TSMC, $100 billion in the next 3 years. SK Hynix announced $108 billion investments in South Korea. Samsung announced a fab in the US. Intel announced two fabs in Arizona also. So a lot of announcements are coming, and that's really unprecedented, these kind of number of announcements. But also, I think it's important to understand these announcements are very, very important, but it takes 2 to 3 years, minimum 2 to 3 years, to bring those factories to start producing chips. And also, we just don't need the advanced manufacturing chips or the advanced chips like CPUs or GPUs or advanced memories. We also need a lot of mature technology chips. And those companies are also, some of the most companies are have a smaller fabs. And if there's no footprint left to grow, then capacity increase is very challenging. So today, if I look at it, the most companies, virtually every company is doing productivity improvement, bottleneck management, the right. yield improvement, as well as incremental capacity increase and our capacity optimization. So we grew 6% capacity this year. Yes, go ahead.
Given that the world runs on chips, Ajit, and that these chips have become an increasingly scarce commodity recently, they've become highly politicized. How do you think the chip race between countries like the US, China, Taiwan, etc., is going to pan out?
That's a very good question, very important question. I think the SEMI, as an industry association, we actually promote a global open market and a global collaboration. We try to be company neutral, country neutral. The reason is this: today, the way the supply chain is established, it has multiple countries involved, not just US and China. There are many countries in Southeast Asia. There's Japan, Korea, they all play a role. The Europe plays a big role in many parts. If you really look at the way the chip is made, you start with silicon substrate, which comes from Japan, Europe, or US. And from silicon substrate to make a chip, mm-hmm. it goes into multiple countries, and it's about 25,000 miles a chip will travel before a chip is ready to ship to customers. So we have a global interdependence. So I think all these geopolitical issues only hurt the problem. But of course, the importance on national security or cybersecurity is very important. I think if we focus on these issues of which are really important for the various countries in the world, I think that will be better than having a geopolitical issues for other reasons coming to slow us down in this industry.